right, so this section here has been done, minus a little bit of area there where our stuff is. We'll come back to that. We have another section over here just like it, and a section over here just like it as well, if you guys are watching. So here's what we just finished, minus our stuff. We have this section, and then here, it's a nice big stain there, and then here. And then we have a long hallway on the other side of those doors we're going to do, as well as a some touch-up on some pews from last time we cleaned them. A couple new stains. So I'm going to try and kind of arrange this over here. Hopefully you guys can see everything. I'm going to be in and out of the shot and stuff, but you get the work order. We're good. If you guys could comment on how you got a notification. I've only done this live on YouTube once before, and people just showed up, and I doubt you guys were just on YouTube at the time. I don't know, could be wrong. But let me know how, if you guys got an email or notification or how that worked. So if you guys have questions about low moisture cleaning in commercial or in a house, please comment. I'm going to check periodically and kind of answer those. We had a couple. An email and it brought you there? Okay, cool. What's up, Andre, Eric, Marcus? How's everybody doing? Well, cool. We're going to keep rolling here and keep cleaning. I'm going to do this little section, so I'm going to turn it so you guys can see my pretty face, and then we'll get going. I just did is I just cut in an edge. So I know I can't get perfectly against that wall if I go like this. So I cut in an edge so that I don't have to hit all the way to the wall when I go back and forth. And that will make it a lot easier for me to clean. I'm gonna grab some more cleaning products to put in there. And some water. Okay, let's see here if you guys have any questions. Man, it's been 12 minutes already. Have a good time. think the lights got halfway turned off on me, so I'm gonna try and find a light switch. And I'll turn this since we're kind of coming this way. Oops, a little stand came off. Perfect. All right, I'm gonna look for a light switch. I'll be back. getting close to finishing this section, and then we'll jump over to the one over there where there's a big stain. All right, let's see if who's on here. Am I boring you guys? Picking that up, but there's also lots of beams above us that are creating pretty gnarly shadows, so it's a little bit hard to tell, but I think in person it's looking great. All right, got another tank here. Should last us the rest of this side. We'll come up the other side. let's start over here. This looks good. Nice and easy. All right, let's see, how's everybody doing? So this is, I'll show you kind of what we're doing here. So there's a lot of lighting up here with beams, and this kind of wall area is casting quite a bit of shadow right here, so it looks not as clean, but it's actually been a huge cleaning difference, but you really can't tell because the camera's not catching it very well. So this section's all done over here, except for where our stuff is. And we'll scoot that over and clean around it in no time. And then this section's done. So now we just have this to do and this. And here's a nice big stain that I think they said they tried to get up and they couldn't. But we brought them about, I don't know, 40 bottles of our spot remover. And then someone might be out here, so it might be, I don't want to distract anyone, but I'll show you guys what we're cleaning out here, just the hallway. Right here, and the other side. Okay, so I'm gonna find a new spot to put this thing here so you guys can see. And I'm gonna have some coffee, because that sounds delightful. Maybe like that. Maybe I'll tilt it up a little bit. Boy, it's harder than I thought. I think we'll take this remote. It's what we used last time. Sorry, shaky, shaky, shaky. I know. Almost there. Then you guys can relax and watch me clean. Very fun, huh? There we go, that's a little better. Not perfect, but that'll do. That'll do. Found some goodies. flip the sides of this so we don't have to worry about it getting in the way anymore. All right, folks, I'm gonna get some more water. Nice hot water. And start mixing some things together here. And I'll be back in just a minute. Big shout out to Brandon and Mario watching live. Thanks for checking in, guys. All right, folks. So we are now done with this section. There's some nice lighting creating some shadows, but this section is totally clean. So is this one all except our little area there. I'm actually just gonna scoot that over a couple feet real quick and then clean that. And then this side is also done. Sorry for the shaky camera, that machine just vibrates your hands. So like, yeah. But anyway, so we're doing this one next here. Shouldn't take too long. Looks like this video has been 57 minutes. I didn't start this at the beginning of the cleaning. I was a third of the way done with that section when I started it, or halfway maybe. So now we're gonna do this one, and I'm really looking forward to that stain there. They don't know what that is, and they couldn't get it out themselves. It looks like coffee, but if they couldn't get it out, I doubt it's coffee. So we're gonna take a look here, try and get that out. And right now I'm going to go ahead and remove those items there. And then we're gonna clean that. You guys can see, not really. Let's put a little bottle cap under here. Well, you can see enough, that's fine. All right, looks like we're on to the next section here. I'm gonna go ahead and do some product mixing here. I'm gonna plug some things in.
You guys having a good time? Hope so, I am. This is a church that we clean very regularly.
All right, let's jet over here now. See if we can set up a nice shot. That'll do. You guys are gonna miss me just for a second. I better turn it. There we go.
Thank you.
All right, guys, I'm going to do that real big stain here. I'm going to kind of cheat over to the other side just for a second. I just want you guys to see this. See right about there. Might take a couple passes, but we're gonna do our best on it. Let it sit, let that product settle for a minute, and I'm gonna keep going this way, and we'll come right back to it. to get some more cleaning product.
So this, I'll kind of explain to you guys, does sound like a chopper, like a helicopter. Steve asked why I would use this method, over steam cleaning. A couple reasons why. One, this lowers the cost for them, right? It's been 78 minutes. We'll finish this before 100 minutes, you know, this section. If we steam clean it with dry strokes, with the cleaning and the pressure needed to remove stains, it would take a lot longer to dry. Also, you know, above and beyond that, this is at least 600 feet from where I parked, probably 700. So I don't think that would even work at all. But the biggest reason is it actually stays cleaner a lot longer with encapsulation. And although we do this church, we're here every other month, this area in most areas besides the pews are only getting done once per year. So they really need that stain resilience, and it does really lower the cost for them because I'll be here, you know, 2 hours or so versus the steam cleaning. It would take much, much longer than that. But the biggest reason is because it does clean better. And that's an opinion, if you will, but I completely believe it. And we've done testing on it from low moisture VLM cleaning like this machine here at the Mytee. And we've also done steam cleaning on, you know, accounts that we do regularly, and I am always shocked at honestly how less frequently we even have to clean it with this method, and how much easier it is. They could have an event in 15 minutes and the carpet would be dry. In fact, that first section we did, the carpet's been dry for at least 20 minutes already. So by the time we actually pack up and leave, all the carpet will be totally dry. It's a pretty great thing. We do low moisture cleaning in homes too. This machine is very heavy for that. We use an Orbiter and a CRB, and we do still use this Mytee machine in a home, but getting that up and downstairs is pretty difficult. But anyway, if you guys have more questions, you can post them. I'm gonna go ahead and refill some containers, get some cleaning product in there, and then we're gonna do this last section, and then we have a little bit here to do along that edge. And then in this area where the cord was, and then we'll jet to the hallway. I don't know if we'll be able to record in the hallway. It didn't look like there was a space to put the iPad, but if there is, I'll do it. If not, I'll catch up with you guys when we do the pews later today. Probably in an hour, we'll have a different live video that we'll post for those pews, and you guys can take a look at how we clean pews low moisture with a variable speed polisher and a microfiber pad. Be back in just a minute. All right, just gonna remove this cord here. And we'll get going.
Back over here, this is almost dry already. Probably another 15 minutes and it will be.
I wanted to mention real quick too, if Steve is still watching, that stain that was over here, it was big, right? So whatever it was liquid and it went through to the other side. If we steam clean that, as it dried, it would evaporate upwards and that stain would reappear. Encapsulation is a crystallizing method, so that does not happen. So that's another reason that this works super well. But anyway, I'll finish up here and get going. All right, guys, I'm gonna go see if there's a place where we can put the iPad in the hallway to do that. If not, I'll just give you a final tour around here and then call quits. All right, folks, so it's kind of busy out there, so I don't want to record anyone that doesn't want to be recorded or anything. So I'll show you what we did, this whole room. I do not know the square footage off the top of my head. I know I have it written down somewhere, but anyway, this is what we did here. We've got a hallway that's about twice the length of this room, maybe 10 or 12 feet wide, and then an entryway. And then if you guys are interested, I'll get some video going on the pews here a little bit later, and we'll get you all set up. Have a great day, guys.